Now, this place takes your breath away. I'm trying to identify the person that was awarded a medal for bravery on the first day of the Somme. Sue's been unable to locate a grave, but she's come up with a stonking idea. The Thiepval Memorial bears the names of soldiers whose bodies were never recovered from the battlefields. If he is one of the missing and his body wasn't found, his real name could be here somewhere.
So what names are we looking
for? We're looking for C.A. Fisher.
Yep.
And we are looking for D.J. Wallace.
OK.
We don't know which one is going to be, if he's here at all.
We need to just split up and go and try and find the South Wales Borderers. The panels are made up of regiments, so you go to the regiment that you're looking for, OK, and then you will look for the names, OK?
OK,
all right,
let's do it.
You go over there, I'll go over here.
Over 72,000 missing soldiers are listed on this monument. The puzzling thing about my medal is that it seems to be dedicated to a man with two names, one of them presumably false.
Gordon Islanders. Essex Regiment, look. Post Office Rifles. I shall never shout at that postman again.
Bruce?
Yeah?
Sue? I think I found it.
South Wales...
South Wales Borderers.
Right.
But look at this. This guy, Fisher,
yeah.
CA. That's correct, is it, sir?
Military
yes.
medal.
Him in.
But look, served as...
Wallace.
That's it. That's it. So we really do now know his real name.
Yeah.
He served under a false name, Wallace. For what reason, we don't know. But his real name is clearly marked there. Cyril Arthur Fishel, military medal.
Cyril Fisher's MM, or military medal, was awarded to common soldiers who had shown gallantry and devotion to duty under fire. If he'd been an officer, he'd have got a better medal, a military cross. Even in death, you were expected to know your place. Whatever our Private Fisher's reason was for giving a false name, he took it to his grave. But one thing's certain, he was a hero.
To get that MM, he did something exceptional.
I think it's wonderful that we've found him. Oh, bless him.
The fact that Private Fisher's name is here means his body was never found. He lies somewhere in the ground where he fell and remains there to this day. Our pilgrimage wouldn't be complete if we didn't pay our respects. Using the map that Sue found, I want to trace the exact spot where he left the trenches and visit the field which is now his grave.
By retracing his steps, we might be able to get a sense of what he saw going over the top that day and why possibly he got that military medal. So let's go and have a look up there.
It's eerily quiet now, where once there were the sounds of the guns and the cries of the wounded and dying. Grass, trees and flowers have regrown where there was mud and shells and bodies. The dips in the land are what's left of the trenches, and our map shows the one where Cyril Fisher spent the last minutes of his life.
This one.
This is it, look.
It's gotta be it.
Definitely. Look, this has got to be the front line trench.
Remember, these were not hardened professional soldiers. They were milkmen and bank clerks and postmen. These were ordinary people plucked out of their daily lives and dropped into hell.
It must have been terrifying, and for all his mates. You've got to imagine they was in this trench waiting to go over the top, right? They had no idea what terror and horror was waiting for them. And then them whistles were to blow. Straight away, the Germans were back up on the parapets and throwing a hail machine gun fire on them. They called in artillery.
German soldiers' diaries talk of mowing the British down like corn.
So you got to remember, after the first 20 minutes, 70% loss. 70% in the first 20 minutes.
OK,
Can you imagine the type of wounds that they were sustaining? People being blown to pieces, legs and arms being shot off, right? Just in this space we are at now. You got no idea how bad this was. This was total war here. And our guy went through it. And our guy is here. So, as I say, all respect to him.
Terrible.
Somewhere here, our man did something so courageous that he was awarded the military medal. Probably he tried to rescue somebody and was killed in the process. All I can tell you is he's here somewhere. His soul is here. The Great War changed everything. The great monarchies of Germany, Austro-Hungary and Russia all collapsed. In Britain, the ruling class genuinely feared a revolution. It didn't happen. But no more would ordinary people bow and scrape to the toffs. Before the war, it was said that on a bus, a common man would automatically give up his seat to a gentleman. Never again. In the Great War, the generals knew what they were doing. They knew what happened when you sent men against machine guns, but they carried on sending them. 20,000 dead in one day alone, including our Private Cyril Fisher. To the generals, they were numbers. 10,000 here, 10,000 there. But every single death was an earth-shattering tragedy for some mother or wife or child. What a fitting place to end our little trip. The facts are, we know his real name. Cyril Arthur Fisher. We've retraced his steps. We've walked the area that he walked on the day, 1st of July, 1916. I mean, I can't in my wildest dreams imagine how terrible that must have been. And it culminated with him giving the ultimate sacrifice.